Hey folks, welcome to Digimento Education. So we are discussing, about 30 questions in the part 1 of Electronic Science paper 3, June 2013. So in this video, I am going to start discussing the questions from question number 31 to question number 75. Okay, let's begin. Thyristors can be turned off by reducing the current below the holding current value, which is definitely correct. So this statement is correct. Applying a negative voltage to the anode of the device, yes, it is also correct. Reducing the gate current, no, it's not relevant. So the option A basically satisfies our explanation. So A option is correct. A 555 timer can be employed in a monostable multivibrator. Yes, it is true. Okay, it can be employed in the monostable multivibrator. A bistable multivibrator, no, this is wrong. This is false. It cannot be employed cannot be used in designing a bistable multivibrator. Yes, it is true for astable multivibrator and monostable multivibrator. So 555 timer is also used for designing the astable multivibrator. So this is also correct. So this is also a true statement. Let's have a look. 1 and 3. So option B is correct. Okay, bistable multivibrator cannot be designed using op-amps as well as 555 timers. Okay, monostable multivibrator and astable multivibrator can easily be designed using op-amps and 555 timer. When a plane wave propagating through a free space, the direction of the field, E is proportional to the direction of propagation. Yes, it is true. Electric field, H and propagation, all of these waves, the propagation of the wave, magnetic field and electrostatic field or electrostatic wave are all perpendicular to each other. So electric field and the propagation is in this direction. So E is perpendicular to the direction of propagation, which is true. H is perpendicular to the direction of propagation, which is true. E is perpendicular to the direction of H, which is true. So option D satisfies our discussion. That's why it is also called as transverse wave. 34. Consider the following statements regarding a semiconductor. Acceptor level lies close to the valence band. Which is true. Okay. Donor level lies close to the valence band, which is false. N-type semiconductor behaves as a conductor at 0 Kelvin, which is false. P-type semiconductor behaves as an insulator at 0 Kelvin. So only 1 and 4 statements are true. So the option C satisfies our explanation. So C is the correct option. A transducer converts. With this question is wrong basically. You just have to select the correct statements. So this question is wrong. This is not about the transducer. You cannot see anything related to the transducer in the 4 points mentioned here. Okay. A potential difference is developed across a current carrying metal strip when the strip is placed in the transverse magnetic field. Which is correct. Okay. Which is correct. A Hall effect is very weak in metals but large in semiconductors. Yes, it is true. It is also true. The Hall effect is very weak in semiconductors but is large in metals, which is false. It is strong in semiconductors while weak in metals. Because we know that RH, mu is equal to sigma RH. Okay, and we know that RH is inversely proportional to the sigma. Okay, and we know that the Hall voltage is proportional to RH. Okay, so for semiconductor, the conductivity is much less than as compared to that in the case of the metals. That's why RH attains a very big value in magnitude for semiconductors than in metals. That's why VH is stronger. Hall voltage is stronger in metals. In semiconductors than in metals. Okay, it is applied in the magnetic measurement of the magnetic field intensity. Hall, it's basically about the Hall effect. So 1, 2, and 4 statements are true. 35. D option satisfies our discussion. So D option is correct. Consider the following statements. Race round condition occurs when a JK flip flop is operated in the toggling mode. When both the inputs are 1, which is true. It occurs in this case. A flip-flop is used to store 1-bit information, which is also true. Okay. Transparent latch consists in a D-type in a flip-flop, which is also true. Master-slave configuration is used in flip-flop to store 2 bits of information, which is absolutely false. So only 1 to 3 statements are true, which is option A satisfies our explanation. Consider the following: oscillator, emitter follower, cascade amplifier, power amplifier. Okay, which of these use feedback amplifiers? So basically oscillator, we just talk about the oscillator. So oscillators basically have feedback. So oscillator has feedback. Without feedback, an oscillator cannot work. The oscillators are like RC coupled oscillator, RC oscillator, or Wien bridge oscillator, Hartley oscillator, Colpitts oscillator, Clap oscillator. All of these oscillators have feedback. So option 1 is true. Emitter follower also has a feedback because it's basically an amplifier. So it has feedback. Cascaded amplifier does not have a feedback. No. Power amplifier does not have a feedback. So only 1 and 2 options are correct. So the option A is correct. So option A satisfies our explanation. Consider the statements regarding an op-amp. All types of negative feedback reduce nonlinear distortion. Which is true. Yes, negative feedback always reduces the nonlinear distortion. All types of negative feedback reduce the output offset voltage. Yes, it is true. Reduce the output voltage but cannot nullify it. There are some cases in which the output offset voltage is nullified, but that is in the ideal case. So it is basically the negative feedback is used to reduce the output offset voltage. Non-inverting feedback increases the input impedance, which is also true. Yes, non-inverting feedback increases the input impedance, which is absolutely true. Inverting feedback decreases the input impedance. Yes, it is also true. So all the statements are true. So we can say that the option D is the correct option. Okay. If an electric field is applied to an n-type semiconductor bar, the electrons and holes move in opposite direction due to their opposite charges. The net current is due to both electrons and holes with the electrons as a majority carriers. Yes, it is true because it is an n-type semiconductor. The sum of electrons and hole currents. Yes, it is true. Both the electron and the hole current will flow in the same direction. So the net current will be the sum of both the currents. It is not equal to the difference between the electron and hole concentration. This is false. So only option 1 and 2 are true. So we can say that the option B is the correct option. A digital multiplexer can be used for which of the following? Parallel to serial conversion, many to one switch to generate memory chip select for code conversion. So parallel to serial conversion, yes, it is true for this. Many to one switch, yes, it is true. It cannot be used for chip select. It cannot be used for code conversion. Okay, so 1 and 2 option are correct. For chip select, you need addresses. Okay, for selecting a particular chip, a chip basically means an input-output devices or any other memory. And for that, you require addresses. That cannot be done with the help of digital multiplexer. As you have already seen in the microprocessors, when you basically interface the memory, the external memory or the input-output devices with the microprocessor, we use the address bus to select a particular input-output device or a memory. And that corresponds to a unique address, which is mapped to a particular device. Okay, so 1 and 2 options are correct. So option C satisfies our explanation. So this is basically assertion and region type questions. Let's have a look at that. An Intel 8085 microprocessor, that lower byte of the address and data are multiplexed. Yes, this is absolutely true. This helps not to limit the number of external pin terminals. Yes, it is also true. It's not to limit. Had it been written like this, that this helps to limit the number of external pins, then it would have been true. Otherwise, it's false. So this statement is false. So option C is correct. Assertion is true. This is true, but this is false. In an op-amp, circuit, when one input terminal of the op-amp is grounded, the other terminal becomes a virtual ground. Yes, it is true. Provided it has a negative feedback. Okay, provided it has a negative feedback. Input impedance of the op-amp is high. Yes, it is true. That's the main reason. But input impedance of the op-amp is high. Yes, is it true? But reason is not the correct explanation of the assertion made. So option B is the correct option. Option B is the correct option. The intrinsic Fermi level of a semiconductor lies exactly at the middle of the energy band gap. Yes, it is true. When I basically discussed about the energy band diagrams of different type of semiconductors like intrinsic, n-type and p-type, we discussed that for intrinsic semiconductor, the intrinsic Fermi level lies just at the middle of the energy band gap, because the density of the available state in the valence and conduction bands are equal. Yes, it is true in that case. So option A is absolutely correct option. The top-down structured programming should be used for developing a programs. Yes, it is true. Of course, you require a proper semantics and syntax should be maintained in a particular program to improve the credibility and readability of the divide of the program, so that the program is legible. The top-to-down structured programming methodology enables us to get readable and easily provable programs. Yes, this is also true. So the option A is the correct option. A processor can reference a memory stack without specifying an address. Yes, it is absolutely true. Absolutely true. The address is always available and automatically updated in the stack pointer. Yes, it is true. So option A is correct. And you can see the reason. This is the main reason behind the processor can reference a memory stack without specifying an address. Because the address is already available and automatically updated in the stack pointer. So there is no need externally. So the option A is absolutely correct option. R is the correct explanation of A. In an optical fiber communication, light rays are guided by the total internal reflection at the interface between fiber core and cladding. Yes, it is absolutely true. The wave or the wave always travels in the coaxial cable through multiple total internal reflections. And that is because the refractive index of the core is far greater than the reflective index of the cladding. But remember, so we can say that R is the correct explanation of A. So the option A is the correct option. Option A is the correct option. Okay. Numerical aperture must be less than 1. Tunnel diode represents a negative resistance characteristics, and when operated in a region, it may be used as an oscillator. Yes, it's absolutely true. It's basically a low power oscillator. Tunnel diode can be used. Tunnel diode is used as a low power oscillator. Okay. Tunnel diode is heavily doped p-n junction having an extremely narrow junction which electrons are unable to tunnel through it. Yes, it is absolutely true, and R is the correct explanation of A. This is the main reason behind it being used as an oscillator, because of its working in the negative resistance region. So option A is the correct option. The part of the root locus on the real axis is not dependent upon the poles and zeros which are not on the real axis. Yes, it is absolutely true. Poles and zeros which are not on the real axis are always occur in conjugate pairs. That's why they are not considered. So option A is correct. A programmable read-only memory can be used as a synchronous counter. Okay, which is absolutely true. Which is true. Each memory location of a programmable read-only memory is programmed and can be read synchronously. No. This is false. Option C is the correct option. A half adder is faster than full adder. Yes, it is true. Absolutely true. Half adder gives only one input while a full adder gives only two output. No, this is false. So option C is correct. Both of them gives two outputs. Consider the following circuit configuration: common emitter, common base, emitter follower, which is also known as a common collector. Emitter following using Darlington pairs. A correct sequence in the increasing order of the input resistances of these configurations. So you just have a look at that. A common emitter has an input resistance of HIE. Common base has an input resistance of HIE by 1 plus HFE. Okay. Emitter follower, which is basically a common collector, is basically HIE plus 1 plus HFE into RE. An emitter following using Darlington pairs, which is Darlington pair. Darlington pair is basically HIE plus 1 plus HFE into RL dash, where RL prime is the input resistance of the output common collector. If we just have a look at the Darlington pair is basically like this. This is your Darlington pair. Okay. This is your Darlington pair. Okay. This is basically your Darlington pair. So the input resistance of Darlington pair is way high than the rest three. Okay. So the option to this is basically your C. If we just arrange them in an increasing order, the minimum will be of common base, then common emitter, then emitter follower, which is common collector, and then the Darlington pair. So the option C is the correct option. Consider the analog and digital converters given below. Successive approximation ADC, dual ramp ADC, counter method ADC, simultaneously. If we just write the propagation delays, SAR type ADC has a propagation delay of N into TCLK. Dual ramp has the highest period, which is 2 to the power N plus 1 TCLK, which is the slowest, but it is most accurate. This is most accurate. Okay. It is most accurate, but it takes a hell lot of time, which is 2 to the power N plus 1 TCLK. Counter method ADC requires 2 to the power n minus 1 into TCLK time. And simultaneous ADC is also known as a flash type ADC or a parallel comparator type ADC, which is the fastest of all. It only takes one clock cycle, 1 into TCLK. In ascending order of their conversion time. So ascending is the minimum to maximum. So option first come fourth, then your first, three, and then two. So you cannot find, so here you can see this pattern, the sequence is not present in any of these options. So it is a bit ambiguous. So had this sequence been there in one of the options, then this would have been the correct answer. So I mark it as an asterisk. So we don't have the correct answer to this, but this is the correct sequence. 4, 1, 3, 2. Okay. Arrange the following following in the order of the decreasing frequency band. So C band, X band, KU band, and K band. So we just have a look: L band, S band, C band, X band, KU band, K band, and KA band. Let me just write the frequency ranges of each band. It's L band is 1 to 2 gigahertz. Okay. S band is 2 to 4 gigahertz. C band is 4 to 8 gigahertz. X band is 8 to 12 gigahertz, KU band is 12 to 18 gigahertz, and K band is 18 to 27 gigahertz, and KA band is 27 to 40 gigahertz. So we have to arrange, if we are required to arrange them in the decreasing frequency bands. So the first comes is the fourth, which is the K band. Then comes the KU band, then comes the X band, and then comes the C band. So the option D satisfies our explanation. Okay. Consider the following cables: single mode optical fiber cable, multi mode optical fiber cable, gridded index optical fiber, and coaxial cable. So basically, if we just talk about the single step index, single mode SISM, which is basically your step index single mode basically has the minimum or the least inter symbol interference and inter modal interference. Okay, but has coherent interference or chromatic interference. Okay, bit rates are very, very high. Okay, bit rates are very, very high. Bit rates and transit time, and it is much faster. And long distance communication is possible in this case. So it is a minimum ISI, inter-symbol interference, or intermodal interference, has chromatic interference, which is basically related to the interference at the source, and that is present in all the index 5 the technologies which are listed down here. It is fastest, bit rates are very, very high, transit times are very minimum transit times, it's faster, okay, faster, long distance communication is possible in the step index single mode, okay. So the fastest of all is this. Then we talk of the multi-mode optical fiber, which is basically your MISM, step index multi-mode, SIMM. SIMM is basically has high intermodal interference. Highest intermodal interference. Okay. Small distance communication is possible. Large transit time and chromatic dispersion do exist in each of these technologies which listed here. Okay. Maximum bit error rate, ISI, and minimum range. Okay. Minimum data rates. If we talk of the step in graded index optical fiber, only graded index multi-mode technology or communication is graded index multi-mode communication is possible in the case of GIOFC, which is graded index optical fiber cable. Okay, so only multi-mode modal transmission. No single mode transmission. If we just talk of this, has the medium ISI, inter-symbol intermodal interference, moderate bit rate and range of communication. And moderate ISI and intermodal interference do chromatic dispersion do exist in this case. Moderate transit time. Okay. And if we talk of the coaxial cable, has all the negative properties. So correct sequence in the increasing order of the data rate. So the minimum would be the coaxial cable has the least data rate possible. Then comes your graded index, second one, which is basically multi-mode optical fiber. So option B satisfies our explanation. First comes your coaxial cable, which has the least data rate. Then comes your multi-mode optical fiber. Then comes your graded index optical fiber. And then comes your single mode step index optical fiber. So the option B is correct option. The interrupts 8085 processor are this. Keep the keeping sequence least priority to the highest priority. So the trap has the highest priority. Then comes your RST 7.5. Then comes your RST 6.5. And then comes your RST 5.5. Okay. So the first priority is of third, which is basically your from least priority to the highest priority is third, which is RST 5.5, then 6.5, 7.5, and then we have a trap. So the option C is the correct option. Now, consider the following frequency spectrum of the electromagnetic wave. FM radio waves, microwaves, visible rain, and X-ray. Write down the frequency spectrum in the ascending order. It's quite simple. So the option D basically here is the correct option. Okay, this does not require any explanation. Consider the following logic families, MOS, TTL, RT, and an ECL. The sequence of these logic families in the order of their increasing propagation delays. So the MOS, if we just talk about the propagation delay, okay, ECL is the fastest of all. ECL is the fastest of all. which is about 1 to 2 nanosecond of, it will take 1 to 2 nanosecond of time. Okay, then we have in the increasing order of the propagation delay from the lower to the highest. Okay, least is basically of ECL, which so 4 comes first. Then we have TTL logic family, then we have RTL, and then we have MOS. So option B is the correct option. The maximum time is taken by MOS transistor. Consider the following steps: etching, exposure to UV radiation, stripping, developing. After a wafer has been coated with the photoresist, the correct sequence of these steps in photolithography is what? Option B satisfies the correct is the correct option. Now, the following microprocessor operations are the part of the interrupt cycle of a control unit. MAR, which is save addresses. PC is a program counter routine address. PC is mapped to MBR and memory to MBR. Which of the following is the correct order of their occurrence? So, the first occurs your MAR, which is save address. Then comes your PC, which is program counter. And then we have MBR. So, the option A satisfies the explanation. Is correct. Consider the following logical families: RTL, DTL, TTL and ECL. We have to arrange them in order of their decreasing fan out. So if we just have a look at RTL, the fan out is basically 3. This is your fan out. Ability to drive the similar, ability to drive the similar gates or similar devices. Okay, DTL, diode transistor logic, has a fan out of 8. Okay, TTL logic family has a fan out of 10, and ECL logic family has the highest fan out, which is equal to 25. Remember, if had there been a MOS transistor as well in the options, then MOS transistor would have been the first choice, because MOS transistor has the highest fan out. Okay, so if we have to arrange them in a decreasing order of the fan out, so option C is the correct option. 4 comes first, then third, then second, and then first. So option C is the correct answer. BJT is basically BJT is basically related to the punch through effect. Okay, so A is mapped to 4. FET is matched to pinch off effect, which is B is mapped to 1. Silicon controlled regulator is basically mapped to controlled rectification, silicon controlled rectifier, so C is mapped to 2, and tunnel diode is mapped to negative resistance characteristic, so D is mapped to 3. So the option which satisfies our explanation is C. Okay, C is the correct option. Frequency modulation is related to the pre-emphasis and de-emphasis, so A is mapped to 4. Okay, double sideband suppressed carrier is related to the balance modulator, so B is mapped to 3. PCM is related to compounding, which is C is mapped to 2. And amplitude modulation is related to envelope detector. So the option which satisfies your explanation is D. Option D is the correct answer. A-stable multivibrator. If we just talk about the A-stable multivibrator, A-stable multivibrator does not have a stable state. So the output basically oscillates between the two quasi-stable states. Okay, so the ASRO multivibrator does not have any stable state; it's a square wave generator. So 63 is so if we just have a look at the ASRO multivibrator, is a free-running oscillator. Sorry, it's not a square wave generator; it's basically a free-running oscillator. So the A is basically is mapped to 2. Bistable multivibrator has a stable state. Okay, has only one stable state. So if we just have a look at this, so B is mapped to bistable multivibrator, has two different stable states, either zero or one. So B is mapped to 1. Monostable multivibrator has only one stable state, so C is mapped to 3. And Schmitt trigger is a square wave generator, so it's also known as a square wave generator. D is mapped to 4. So the option C satisfies our explanation. Okay. Gun diode is basically junctionless device. So A is mapped to 1. Solar cell is basically a single junction device. So B is mapped to 2. MOSFET, MOSFET is basically a double junction device, so C is mapped to 4, and silicon controlled rectifier is basically a triple junction device, so D is mapped to 3. So the option B satisfies our explanation. Option B is correct. Capacitive transducer is related to displacement. So A is related to 3. Thermocouple is related to the temperature. Okay, so B is mapped to 4. Load cell and diaphragm. Load cell is basically mapped to the torque, and diaphragm is related to the pressure. So D is 1. So the option that satisfies the explanation is B. B is the correct option. This is a question of 66. Sorry, make a change here. It's basically D. It's D option, which is the correct option. Okay. Ampere's law is related to the magnetic flux density at a point. Force on a charge, force due to a current carrying conductor, electric flux density at a point, and magnetic flux density as a point. So Ampere's law is related to 4. Biot-Savart law is related to the force due to a current carrying conductor. So B is related to 2. Coulomb's law is the force on a charge, which is C is related to 1. And Gauss law is related to 3, which is electric flux density at a point. So D is related to 3. So the option that satisfies your explanation is B. Okay, B is the correct option. Let's have a look at the next question. Immediate addressing. So LXI H2050 is basically an immediate addressing mode. So A is related to 3. Implied addressing, or the implicit, it is also known as implicit addressing mode. Implicit addressing mode is RRC, which is rotate right without carry. That's basically a rotate right without carry. Okay, so B or implicit addressing mode, so B is related to 4. Register addressing mode is this. Move A and B is register addressing mode. C is related to 2. And direct addressing mode is LDA. Load accumulator direct. 30FF. So, accumulator will be stored with the data, with the 8-bit data or 1-byte data. Okay, it was stored 1-byte data. Addressed by 30FF. Okay, addressed by, referenced by 30FF address. So, it will be, the 8-bit data will be stored in the accumulator, which is already stored in the memory addressed with 30FF. Okay, so the D is mapped to 1. So the option that satisfies our explanation is A. Option A is the correct option. Now simplex communication is unidirectional. So A is related to 4. Half duplex is bidirectional, but the communication does not take place simultaneously. Okay, half duplex is bidirectional, and this bidirection and not at same time, but not between same two points. So B is related to 1. B is related to bidirectional, but or not at the same time. So B is related to 3. Full duplex is bidirectional at the same time between the two same points. So C is related to 2, and full duplex communication is related to 1. So D is related to 1. Bidirectional at the same time, but not between the two same points. So D is related to 1. So the option A satisfies our explanation. So option A is the correct option. Drift current. Now, drift current is due to the drifting of the charge carriers under the presence of an electric field. So A is related to 2. Einstein's equation is basically related to the law of conservation of charge. So B is related to 1. Diffusion current is basically related to the concentration gradient. So C is mapped to 4, and continuity equation is related to the thermal voltage, which is D. Okay, So the option A satisfies our explanation. So option A is the correct option. PN diode, PN junction diode can be used as a rectifier diode. So A is related to 3. One of the example of a PN junction diode is a Zener diode, which is also used in the rectification circuit. LED is a light emitter, so B is related to 2. PIN diode acts as a light detector, so basically C is related to 4. PIN diode is used as a light detector, and tunnel diode is used as a low power microwave oscillator, so D is related to 1. So the option C satisfies our explanation. So option C is correct. Okay, this is basically a paragraph, and based on this paragraph we have to answer the questions asked ahead. Okay, so please go through this paragraph. I am going to answer the questions. Okay, a scheme in which several channels are interleaved and then transmitted together is known as. We are referring to the channels, which means that we are referring to, indirectly referring to the frequency. Okay, we are indirectly referring to the frequency. So that's basically frequency division multiplexing. So A is the correct option, which is FDM, frequency division multiplexing. Microwave link repeaters are typically 50 km apart. Why? Because the Earth's curvature is considered to be almost a straight line when we consider distance from one point to another point as 50 km. After every 50 km, the curvature of the Earth slightly bends. It's no more a straight line. That's the reason. Because of the curvature of the Earth, repeaters are kept at 50 kilometers distance from each other. So C option is the correct option. C is the absolutely correct answer. Okay. Time division multiplexing can be used with CPM only. Combines 5 group into a sub groups. No, it's not correct. Stacks 24 channels in an adjacent frequency slots. No, it's also incorrect. Interleaves pulses belonging to different transmissions. Yes, it is absolutely true. That's the main function of a time division multiplexing. Okay. Broadband long distance communication was originally made possible by the advent of geostationary satellite, repeater amplifier, high frequency radio or telegraph cable. So it's only due to the repeater amplifier. So the 74 the option, correct option is the B option. Okay, and the last question is, the number of repeaters along a coaxial cable link depends on whether separate tubes are used for the two directions of transmission. Bandwidth of the system is absolutely correct option. Okay, it only depends on the bandwidth of the system. How many repeaters that you have to place in the coaxial cable link, that only depends on the bandwidth of the system. So the option B is the correct option. Okay, thank you guys. This ends the paper 3, June 2013, Electronic Science.